as a virtual room. So this is what the LabVIEW supports. Not only this, I've given the simple example. If you go with the big environmental, industrial environmental, you can see that you can create a virtual instrument. See, I can say one thing is LabVIEW, it is meant for instrument control. We have enormous functions to be controlling our devices. Okay, so this is what the LabVIEW abbreviations. So graphical programming language that allows for instrument control, data acquisition, and pre-post processing of acquired data. So this is basic about your LabVIEW. You should remember that LabVIEW, it is totally, it is a virtual instrument. So now onwards, whatever the file we are creating from the LabVIEW, it's all VI. VI stands for virtual instrument. Okay. So in graphical programming, it normally depends on some of the icons. Here we doesn't have any text language. Here it is all functions. Already functions are available. You should know the logically to implement your program. And before that, we come to know that how the data has transmitted through the functions. So this is the main concepts of graphical programming. So we'll have an examples, then we can come to know that what might be the difference between text-based language as well as the graphical programming. Okay, so I request all the participants who are there, install the LabVIEW, please open the LabVIEW. Along with me, you can practice with that, okay? Anything, any you have the doubts, you can text me in problems, we'll solve immediately. And some who are not having the LabVIEW, please understand the concept. And any doubts are there, we'll discuss with respect to that. Okay, so once you open the LabVIEW tool, okay, you will get the LabVIEW 2019. So you go to the file system. Go to the new VI. As I said, all the file, it is in extension with the VI, virtual instrument. Okay, so create the new VI. So one more information I need to tell that in any applications, let's say a simple application like WhatsApp or Facebook, how it looks. The front panel, it is very reliable for the users. I don't know what the back end it is happening. I know only how to use the part. Like text message I can transmit or receive or the video I can do all the, but user doesn't know that how it is transmitted to the particular destination. That is in the back end. We know only the front view. In front view, it is very reliable for the user to understand that application. So normally, all the applications to design the front view, it has a different language is required. And back end, it is required some other language to implement on that. So, but in graphical programming, it is not much required. Automatically, the program itself, we have the front panel to be implemented. So once you open the VI, we'll get the front panel there where we are going to be design the front view. And respect to that, we need to design our algorithm in the block diagram. Okay, let me take any one example. Yeah, like in WhatsApp only. In the front view, we can see only the input and output. Like I can give the text input. I can read the text or read the videos or whatever the images. So remember in your front panel, we have only the input and outputs. So respect to that, here, all the input we called as a controls. Now onwards, whatever the inputs with respect to the variables, we called as a controls.
LabVIEW is not seen.
Excuse me, sir. Screen is not visible. visible side.
So it not shared. It not shared to WebEx. It not shared to WebEx, sir.
Screen is not visible to us.
Sir, screen is not there.
Sir, you have to share, sir.
Okay, now you are getting.
Vandila, sir.
Getting?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Please mute your. Okay, please open the file and new VI. Once we open the new VI, we can come to know that our front panel, where we are designing our front view. With respect to that, we need to implement the algorithm or any functions. So in that log diagram. So once you open that VI, you made it as a control T. That gives you a tiled your pages. So you can see the page one after the other. Okay. So let me take one example. Simple example. I need to add the two numbers. So what I supposed to do that? To adding the two numbers, in the sense it should be a numerical values. Okay. And I require two inputs as well as one output. So just I'll briefing that later. I'll come back to that. What are the variables and how you define the variables with respect to their data types and what kind of data types all are there. But here I need to say that it's different with your text level language as well as your graphical level language. Okay. Just I'm taken one example here. Just I'm right clicking here. I go to the numeric. In this numeric, we can find out all kind of input and as well as an output. So as I said that control, it is an input. Indicators are an output. Remember. So in this example, I required the two inputs. Let me take one input. So let me, this is a numeric input. I tell you later that what is the data type of this? It is a taken as in 32 bit or 64 bit. It is a float variable or unsigned variable, or it is only a real variable. So later I can explain you that. I'll take an example, but I need to know that what is the difference in text as well as the graphical programming. Okay. With respect to that, I need to take one more input. So variable name as B and taken as a indicator. I'm taken as a sum. So this is where you are defining or creating a front page. Okay. With respect to your variable in the block diagram, I'm getting an icon. See, you can see that. So this is an icon. In this icon, I can view this as a node. This is a node. Okay. Each icon have a node. See, this node is away from this icon. It means that it indicates that it is a control. It is an input. Like, see, in my home, I can take the current, the plug. So that is an input I can take from away from that. I give it to the bulb. So it like the whatever the node towards to it. So like that. So the same way, it, whatever all the icon have the individual nodes. So this is where I need to wire. I need to wire the icons with respect to my function. So as I know, in the front panel, I'm getting all the icons as input and outputs. You can design with respect to the user reliability. User can understand easily what this application meant. So with respect to that, I can give the name of the this. Okay, this is in addition. Whatever the design you can make, I come later for this, how to do all the designing part to be understand for the user. Okay, so we come to the block diagram. So here we'll find enormous functions with respect to your applications. So what kind of functions we are getting here? Right click on this. You can see that it have the structures. We have all different kind of structures we are studying in C or C++ or Java, for loop, while loop, and case structures and formula node or time structures and in place element. All we have as an icon only. Okay, so we came to know that how we supposed to use this icon to be implemented in our program. This is the one concept we want to learn. So in this 4 days period, we need to learn programming all this kind of using structures along with your numerical and comparison and Boolean, whatever all the one we can come to understand that using that program. Okay. And we have the arrays functions. We have the clusters. Clusters is mean by your collection of variables. Okay, what we are discussed about the structures and the class. So here we called as a clusters. Okay, and we have the so many Boolean functions we have. We have the string functions we have, and numerical functions and comparison functions. See, yesterday we had discussed about the certification program. So first basic level certification program is CLAD certification. So there we adding up the core one and core two concepts. So this is where the first CLAD certification, you need to be understand this part. If you know this part while using your program, then you can take up the examination. Okay, later we'll discuss regarding about the CLAD certification. Let me come to this addition program. Okay, where I'll supposed to take? So this is your numerical function. Let me take for the addition. So take place your addition functions there. So this function gives what you supposed to give the input. You want to be a help of this, make a control help. It gives that help, that is a context help regarding with that function. So we have the two input with respect to that. We have the outputs. Okay. So then connected to this two inputs, so this is what we called as a wiring, and you just connected to the sum. See, now this is just one program. I did it actually. It is a simple program, addition of two number. Okay, come back to the front panel. Press again Control T. You can tail the pages. Now, what I want to know that is the difference in whatever the C programming as well as your graphical programming. See, I knew that in C programming, I need to do the addition of two number. First, what I supposed to do that? I need to include my header files. It supports to the which are the keywords if I use in the text level language. And after that, I need to declare the variables. What kind of variable I supposed to use for addition? It's an integer or okay. So here need not to worry about what the type of your variable. Need not to worry about your data type of that variable. Just later I can explain how default it is taken itself. Okay. So this is what I did the program. I'll go and run it continuously. This is a single shot run. This is a continuous run. Later I'll come back to all the function of your menu bar. Just I'm running this. Your program is running. In real time, you can change the values. You can change the inputs. You can observe that the data, how automatically has changed. So in text level languages, this options is in real time changing that values, changing the variables content.
Changing that values, changing the variables
Google content. Drive link to share agate. Share adu Google. Beda, yavudukku beda. Ivada Google Drive link kodute simple avarge. Adakke upload maadisbidi. Abhi sir post maartare WhatsApp ge. ATM ni family.
Anupama madam, can you please
share again. everyone listen for students ma'am google kalsi adine ms teams chat maadi sir mele nu helbidu ma'am whatsapp group alli ondu whatsapp group alli ondu drive link share agide adina nimge meeting kelagade post iruttala alli share maadbidi illa whatsapp alli adru kalisi students ge ಅವರಿಗೆ ಅಪ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡಕ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊತಾರೆ ಗೂಗಲ್ ಡ್ರೈವ್ ಅದು ಹಾ ಗೂಗಲ್ ಡ್ರೈವ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಅದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕಳಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಅಪ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊತಾರೆ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಟಿಎಂ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಆಗಿದೆ
ಅನುಪಮ ಮೇಡಂ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ದ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ See now I am changing the inputs automatically that whatever I am getting the output here. See I need to know that how the data flow it is. See in the text level language I know that the control it is passed from the top down approach. Okay, from started with the main and each coming down by step execution of your all the code. Once it is executed, it's come out of prompt with respect to your way of writing the program. But here you can observe that the data flow, remember here in the graphical programming, it is the data, it is flowing towards from left to the right. You can see that the data is from the icon, from A and B icon, the data it is flowing from the left to the right. Okay, this is one difference in graphical programming. Okay, and one more is in the difference is see, while you are writing the text programming, you should know the syntax. What, how do you supposed to use that function? Let's say printf, you want to be right, you should know the syntax of that. Similarly for all the functions, you should know the syntax, and only it can be you can write the program. But in graphical program, syntax is not required. That is our knowledge, but here is not required any syntax in the graphical programming. And second difference is let's say I know the logic to be implement, so how do you find the logical errors? See, this is the only main drawback in graphical programming, is finding the logical errors. In text based language we can come to know the where may be the logical errors, but in graphical programming is very difficult to be finding the logical errors once if you have the big program. Okay, that is one main drawback in graphical programming. And second thought is in text level language, finding in errors. So once you write the program, then only you can come to know that what kind of errors it is available in text level language. But here, while wiring your icons using the functions, once you're finding mismatching, that automatically you will find the errors. Let's say how it's supposed to be like. See, I want to be I see this broken wires. See, there may be errors. Let's say I connected to both the inputs together. Is it possible to connect input? Like I need to be assigned the values of A is equal to B as an input. Is possible? So there is an error. So itself only I can see that there is an broken wire. So I can find out the errors. Okay. So likewise, these are the difference between a text based as well as your graphical programming. Let me brief the contents with text based as well as the graphical programming. See, in text based programming, syntax must be known to do programming. Graphical programming, here the syntax is a knowledge, but is not required for programming. So in text-based programming, the execution of a program from top to bottom, and here the left to the right options, the data flow, it is from the left to the right. And to check an error, the program has to compile or execute it in your text-based programming. But in graphical program, you need not to finding the errors. Automatically we can came to know that where the broken off wires, there may be an error. Okay. In text-based, as I discussed, a front panel design need extra coding or need extra works. But in graphical programming, that is a part, a front panel is a part of your program. And text-based programming is non-interactive. As we see now, addition of two number, it is so easy to implement. So that's, I can come to know that graphical programming is highly interactive. So the next, the difference is the text-based program, where the programming is a conventional method. But here, the programming is data flow programming. And one more drawback I said in the graphical programming, finding the logical error is easy in the text-based, but in graphical programming is very difficult, quite complicated to find the logical errors. And one more concept, as we came to know that in, if you know the C programming, C++ programming functions we are using. So there we know that how you pass the parameter through the functions as a variable or as a address by using a pointers. So these are all some of the difficulty to be understand to passing a parameter to from to your subroutine, as I called as a function. But in graphical programming, it is very easy to pass a variable from your main VI to your sub VI. Here I called as a sub VI, that is what a function or a subroutine. So this is a differences what we came to know in text-based as well as a graphical. So now we come to programming level. As we know that once we open the VI, that is a virtual instrument, we have the front panel. In front panel, all the input we called as a control and all the outputs we called as an indicators. Remember? Okay. So in the block diagram, we find out enormous functions. All functions is wired together to implement your applications. Let me start what are all the information I can come to explain with the programming itself only. We'll come to the okay, are you visible the screen? It is okay, fine for me. Now, in your VI, in graphical programming lab view, we have the three data type. Remember, one we have the numeric, one we have the Boolean, and another one we have the strings. These three are the data types. As we implementing any programs, declaring the variables, it should be a numerical, or it should be a string, or it should be a Boolean. These three data types are available. So let me see that how you're defining the variable with respect to its data values. Let me take one numeric. See, I'm taken, this is a numeric as I input. This is the control. I'm taken the indicators. This is your indicator. See, I want to know this numeric is what kind of data type. Okay, let me directly connect it to this. I connect it to this. It is connected. So I want to know the data representation of this. See, it is, we have the data representing this icon. It is a double precision. And if it is a long, it is integer value. or unsigned value. I'll go to take all the three output variables. Let me see that how the difference between all these three data types. See, I connected, I'm taken all the three outputs with respect to your one data type, numeric. I'm just connected it to the all the values. I'm just connected to your input to all the three variable outputs. I'm changing that data representation. Okay. Here I'm changing to the long, only the integer. You can see that the color has changed. Okay. And there is a red color in the icon. There is maybe a glitch or there may be an error in this. Okay. Let me take another data representation of unsigned long. It's all 32 bits variables. So one I'm taken as in data representation with double precision. It may be what kind of variable it take, we'll see that. Similarly, I'm taken as an integer value of 32 bit and unsigned 32 bit. Okay. All this is a numerical variable with different data representation, changing their values. Next, I'll give some input in this. Let me give the inputs. So 3.6, I given the input. So in all the outputs, how the values will be getting here? See this, the first, it's a double precision. What I given the input, I'm reading the same value as 3.6. In the integer value, here I'm getting the integer value, where the data representation is integer of 32 bit. I'm taken as not floating value, it takes only the integer value. That is, proximity of 3.6 is equal to the 4. Similarly, it is unsigned value, it taken as in, because 3.6 is unsigned value, it is given as your 4 as an integer value. Let me give the negative number. Next, I given as a minus 3.6. What is the value it will going to be taken? Let me run this program. See, it is taken as a minus 3.6, and this is as taken as a only integer of even signed or unsigned, minus 4. And this is unsigned variable, so that's why it is not taken minus 3.6. It is given as a 0. So this is how we can represent that variable of your numeric. See, as we are defining in the C programming, like int, float, double. So like this way, I can represent that numerical variable in this forms. One is unsigned variable, signed variable, and whatever your double precision, that is minus 3.6, where I'm getting. Okay, this is the one we are representing numeric data type. Clear? So next we'll come to the Boolean functions. See, all the switch indicates your inputs, that is a control. Only the LEDs are your indicators. Let me take any one of the switch. I'm taken the switch. So here I'm taken one indicators. I'm taken as an indicator. I connected. So whenever it is true, LED will be on. Let me run with the continuous. So whenever it is true, my LED will be on. You can see that the data flow, it is flow from left to the right. Okay. Similarly with the character variables. So take the string, string control. I'm taking the string control. And similarly, we have the string indicator. String indicator. Just connected to wire between two this. So whatever you are given the string input, so I'm getting a string output here. So this is the three data types. One we have the numeric, and one we have the Boolean, and one we have the string. With respect to that, we have enormous functions in block diagram. Let me see, in the numeric, we have the functions, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, increment, decrement, whatever, absolute value, round up, square, cube, all the functions are available with respect to your numerical value. We can implement any mathematical expressions with your variables. Okay. And similarly, comes to the Boolean, we have the Boolean functions, all the logical expressions we can implement. See, for example, I want to read the IR sensor value. See, IR sensor value is a digital value. it's a whenever it is getting as 1 or 0, I can read it. So I want to be manipulate, I can configure some of the logical expression. So I can use my logical operational gates to implement that kind of applications. So you want to do some of the string applications, string manipulations. You have the string functions. Okay. So for example, you want to find a match your string in your database. Any person you want to be matched. How do you match? You need to compare with particular data set with your age or address or the name, whatever ID or something like that. So how do you supposed to be implemented by using this program? We have so many functions, string functions. Okay, finding the string length, concatenating the string, finding the subset. Subset in the sense in the part of a string, I need to be find out, replace the string. All the string functions are available. So using these three variables, we have all the three functions. Along with, we have some of the structures. These structure functions we can use to be implemented in our applications. So this is basic explanations of your variables along with the functions. Okay, so let me come to what may be the functions in block diagram or in front panel, how we can see debugging the code, or what are the functions are there in the menu bar, or what other way to be implement our program. Okay, this all we can see in all these 4 days. See, how do we implement the functions, like how do you create the sub VI, okay, and how do you implement the for loop or while loop or whatever the way implementing the programs. So these are all we can understanding in all these 4 days. So now let me see that. Let's say I want to take addition of 2 number. I taken all the things. Let me explain what may be this. All the functions are available. See, this is the one icon. It is a single shot run. It is a single shot. You want to continuously run, infinitely you want to run. So this is the one, it is the icon to be continuously run. And this is what, where you are abrupt the stop the execution. And this is the one you want to pause the application. Okay. So now these are only just for arranging your icon with respect to these are all we called as a grids. With respect to grids or the edges, it is top edges and vertical edges and maybe a bottom edges. Likewise, we need to be arranged. How we supposed to? See, this is not in aligned. So let select all these things, place your vertical. So all your icons are left aligned. So likewise, I can use these functions to be design of your front panel. Okay, with this we have so many decorations way to be designed. Let me take this frame. I can take this. Okay, I can give the some of the text here. So just test variable, I given this test variable. So I want to change the font, coloring, anything you want to make reliable to the user, your front panel, we can design it here. Okay, so this is where all the functions are available in the front. That comes to the block diagram functions. What are the things as available, how to debug or how to do your coding in the block diagram. As with these things are common for all the one. So this is where you highlight the execution. Let me run this program continuously. Your program is running. Okay, I want to be highlight that execution, how which variable has taken first the values and how the data has flows from left to the right. So I want to know that. Okay, so you want, you make it as an highlight of this execution, right? So with this I want to wash the values. So for example, here what the value it is coming out of this wire. So then we have the wire values. You just click on this, click on the particular on the wire. So your watch window, it is opening. In this, it is mentioning that your variable name and the value, okay, and particularly what time it is updated time and the date it is mentioned. You just you can watch and you can record all the values in real time, okay. Similarly, you want to this wire value, so we have like connected to the another wire is to boolean, so you can see that it is a true or false. I can in real time I can observe that. So I can change this value, I make it as false, so immediately the watch window shows that the value of that wire is a false, okay. So this is how we can see that what is the front panel and the block diagram, okay. Let's come to the simple example to be understand the functionality of your LabVIEW, okay. So first we'll understand that numerical values. With this we'll come to know how to evaluate your mathematical expressions using your graphical programming, okay. So first one things you need to understand about variables, that is a numerical variable, how to define the numerical variable as a float or integer or signed or unsigned variable. Here we need to how to change the modification with respect to data representation of that variable. This is how need to be make. Let me create one new VI. So I will take one simple example to show the using your numerical variables. Okay, here I written one example, y is equal to a cube plus 3ab squared plus log of a. How I'll supposed to be implement this boolean expression in my graphical programming? So here how many variables are there? First we should know that. So have the two input variable a and b, and only one is an output as y. Likewise, I need to take the variable first in my front panel. After that, I can use that functionality where addition or multiplication or any logarithmic expression or trigonometric expression, anything I can take up this functions and implementing this whatever the expression. Let me first take the variables. I'll have the two inputs variable. So for that, what I supposed to do? Come to the front panel, go to the numeric. In the numeric, I'll take one variable as an input, a. This is a. And similarly, I'm taken as one more variable, it is b. And one output should be there. Numeric indicator, this is your y. So in my Boolean expression, what I mentioned here, it is, I have the two inputs, a and b, and one is an output. This function I need to be implemented, okay. So likewise, I taken as a two inputs with respect to one output. So what is the first one I supposed to do that? So that first we have an value, it is a cube. How will find the a cube of that variable, okay. Go to your numerical functions. Here we can find out only the square value, okay. So how do you get the a cube? I can make multiplication the same by same. At the same time, I can do that a squared a cube. I can do that. But we have one more trigonometric function, power function. Okay. So where I'll get it? See, in this function, we have the mathematics. Go to mathematics. We have an eliminatory method functions. Here you can see that we have the trigonometric function, sine, cos, tan. Second values, give the input and get that particular values, or you can go to the exponential one. So here you can find out that 2 power x, x power y, a logarithmic function, base 10, base e, whatever the way, the all the functions are available. So here I need a cube. So I'll take this x power y. So I'll take it here. This is your x power y. So I want to know which is the one it is a power, which is the one it is a base values. So make it as a control H for this. Move your cursor onto that icon. You can see that power of X, X is your base. in the bot upper one the line as you are buying. Okay, so first connect it to the base value. I connected to this x. Here I need to give the power, how much it is a value of 3. Where I'll get the 3 value? Go to the numeric, we have the numeric constant. Take the numeric constant, the constant value it is 3. Connect it to this. Now the output of this, it is a cube. Similarly, I need to do it one more function. What is that? 3 into a into b square. So I need to do that first b square of this value. So we have the square value of this. So we'll get the b square. Okay. And we have 3 into a into b. So I'll have the a here. I'll take the numeric constant. The value it is 3. 3ab. I want the multiplication. In the multiplication, I have the 2 inputs, but here I have the 3 inputs. How am I supposed to do with the 3 input? So I can make the first 2 and I can cascade with one more function. That's also I can do. Or you can go to the numeric. We have the compound arithmetic. We have the compound arithmetic. Yes. So here enormous, any n number of inputs I can connect with different mode of operation. So once you move on to the cursor here, you get the form, click on this, change the mode. What the mode you wanted? Addition, multiplication, and or XOR. So here I want to make it as a multiplication. So I made it as a multiplication. Okay. I repeating once again, how I supposed to multiplying 3 variables. Right click on this, go to numeric, we have the compound arithmetic. Click on this, place it here. Place your cursor onto this, you'll get the arrow key and you can drag this. So enormous n inputs you are connected to here. Okay. And change the mode where you, what kind of application you want to do it, addition or multiplication, anything. Okay. So delete this. Here I want only the 3 input, make it is only the 3. Okay. So first input is from A, connected to A. And one more it is B, and one more it is 3. So it is multiplied here. So operation is 3ab squared, it is happened. Next, I want to be do it log A. So as we know that, so for example, I didn't get where may be the log. I didn't know the path of it. How else supposed to do that? Go to search. So in the search engine, you want to type what is the functionality you wanted. You type the log. Okay. You can see that logarithm of base 2 or logarithm of base x or logarithm of base 10. Let me take any one log of base 10. Okay. So I'm taken as a log of base 10. So what my expression is? Log of a. So here you can see that it is, make a control H, you can see that logarithm of base 10, given the input of x, you get as log of x. So here in the, my expression is required as log of a, I'm getting as log of a. So this is how I can realize with my Boolean expression. So now all this module I can need to be add. So take the addition of, see I have the 3 outputs, I connected to the addition. How am I supposed to go to this? Go to the numeric. So I can cascade with the addition or I can go with the compound. So I have the 3 input of line, so I can do 3 lines out there. Tell him to stop. So next we connected all the one to your input. So mode change operation to be add. So it is an addition of all this. So this output should be connected to Y. So this is a simple Boolean, whatever the mathematical expression, I can realize by using your functions. Okay. So let me change there something input of this what might be getting the output. We can observe this. Let me run continuously. You can see that the value with respect to your Boolean expression of your AQ plus AB squared plus log A, if your variable A is given as 2 and B are given as 3, we're getting the Y as 62.01 value. Okay. So with this, we can simplify a simple mathematical expressions. Fine. So now what I supposed to do is, see, as a variable, I can come to know that in C and C++, where in Java, how do you define a local variable or global variable or static variable? What is the use of a local variable? What is the use of global variable? Okay. So I need to be know that. See, for example, here the value as A, I sharing with this function or this function or this function. I can create this variable as a locally for this function or this function, this function. How I'm going to create locally? Okay. So right click on this. We have the create. Okay. So local variable. I'm repeating. I want to create the variable as a local. Right click on this. Go to create. Go to local variable. Now this variable, it is a locally created. So now I don't want to connect it to this. I'm connecting all the variable to the local variable. I need not to use this variable. I created here as local variable now. So I change to the mode. Change to read because an input. Okay, I just connected to this local variable to this. Later you can observe that just copy and paste. So the same local variable connected to this. Now we can observe that you'll get the same result with this, but how before and how that. It is clear, sir.
Sir, repeat the local variable, sir.
Okay. I redoing that. See, this is a variable, right? So right click on this, create. We have the local variable. Click on this, we'll get the local variable of this A. Whatever we have the variable, it is a local variable here. Okay. See, once you create the local variable of your block diagram, all the variable, it is showing that this is what the which is the one variable you want to use it as a local. So I'm taken as a here. So this is as an indicator now. It's look an indicator. I want to change this mode operations, change to read, because before it wasn't write operation because an indicator. But I taken as in a control. So I changes to the control mode. Now this is a input. I give it the input to this same variable. Okay. Same one more local variable I want to create for this, the same variable as A. Copy and just copy and paste it. Here you want to A or B. You can use A only. Take A variable. Okay. Okay. Here I need not to take A variable. I'm taking the direct physical variable. I just connect it to this. Now we'll see that what is the drawback in local variable while running our program. So this is physically I'm taking A and B variable. Here these two are the local variable. Clear? Let me run this program. See now, the value has taken from the physically where you are defined A and B first, and later you'll go to the local variable. Are you observing, sir? So I'm redoing that. So I'm running continuously. I'll go with the highlight of execution. See, first the values here it is taken, executed this, and then come to the local variable and executing this. So first physical variable where you have taken the values, and later it transfer your data to your local variable. So that's what you are using more local variable. Your execution of your program made bit slow, not more slow. It is a bit slow. That's what you don't use more local variables. We can use whenever it is necessary, but simply you don't want to use the more local variable. It reduces the speed of execution. Fine. So this is how we can use our numerical variable and implementing any Boolean expressions. In that we can learn that how to create the local variable. Later I'll come back to that, how to create the global variable. Okay. So this is one functions. Same way, I'll go with some of the Boolean expression I need to realize it. Okay. I'll take some Boolean expression. Let's say one variable is M, A bar B plus B C bar. So this is one Boolean expression I want to be implemented in my lab view. So here, how many variables are there? A, B, and C, three variables are there. So let me do this. Okay, I'll take one more variable, because I want to use the compound arithmetic. So I can use that D. Okay. This is my expression. So expression is M is equal to A bar B plus B C bar D. I need to be implement this Boolean expression. Okay. So here how many variables are there? Three variables are there. A, B, C, D. Four variables are there. Let me take the four variables. I'm going to be implement one output. Okay. So here, go to the Boolean. Take this variable. Let me take it as some other name like A, and take one more variable as BB. C. So four variables are there. One output should be there. Take the one output. Output always, we know that it is an LED. So similarly, it is created your icons here. So A, B, C, D, four variables are there. First, I want to do is A bar B. How do you make this A bar? So we have the Boolean function. You make an inversion of this. Okay. And then we need to do the AND operation with B. So directly I can go with the compound arithmetic. So take this compound arithmetic. So change this operation as AND gate. Change this operation as AND gate. Okay. So here I need to use that A bar. So this I supposed to connect it to this A bar. What I supposed to do? I should invert. So go to that particular icon node. Right click on this. There is an invert. So there is an invert. So you can observe that it's a bubble. It indicates that whatever you are given the input to this particular line, it is inverting in. So that it is A means it is A bar. Okay. Next, I connect it to the B. So what I'm getting the output is A bar B I'm getting. Next, B C bar D, B C bar D here. So same way here also I creating the local variable for Boolean expression. So create the local variable. So for the BB, I change to read operation. Change to read now. So I'm taken this local variable for B, C, D. So here same way, I am taken the compound arithmetic here. Three variables are there. Change the mode operation as an AND gate. Okay. So here it is B, I'm connecting into this. Okay. Change, sorry, I made addition here. So change to AND. Okay. So now I can see that here I made it as an AND. So this is your numeric. This is a Boolean. There is an error. I can't assign the values to your addition of your Boolean expression. Okay. So that's what it is, a given error. It is a mismatched data type. So that's what I changed the mode operation with AND operation. So this is your B and this is your C bar. So I should make it as an invert here. Clear. I think it is visible. Okay. So one is I made it as A bar. I made right click on this. I made an invert here. If it is not invert, there is no bubble in that. So now it is A. So if you want to be invert, make it as an invert. So that is A bar B. And this is your, I created for this as a local variable P. And this is your C bar. And this is your D. So both are AND operation. These two I should be made it as OR operation. So go to this Boolean, take it as OR, connect it to OR. So now you are connect both the input to the OR gate and just I connect it to the Boolean. Okay. Let me run for your continuously run. Change the input, you can observe that what may be your getting the outputs. Okay, with this you can give the input respect to your Boolean expression and okay, so you can give the values to the Boolean expression, you can observe that what kind of input I supposed to get an output of this Boolean expression.
Sir?
Any doubts, madam?
Yeah, sir. I have one doubt. Without taking the local command directly into Y from DB, sir?
Not audible, madam. Can you speak loudly, madam?
Yeah, sir. Without taking local variable, can we wire from BB, sir?
Yes. I can directly, because I need to be explainable how do you create the local variable. That's what I made it. So I just okay, I taken okay. This. Okay.
Okay.
I
sir,
made
okay.
It as a.
Okay, sir.
Oh, okay. So in the Boolean expression also we can do Boolean function also we can do enormous equation by simplifying with this. Okay. So as we came to know that using the numerical expressions, okay, and Boolean expressions, how implementing that. Okay. So now I'll take one more simple applications. Like, just I want to know that the number is even or odd. How do you implement that program? Okay, take the number. I need to check that number. It is an even or odd. Okay, so simple way. What I supposed to do? I take the numerical one. Okay, this number I want to be check. It is in even or odd. As we know that once it is divided by 2, the remainder is 0. So I'll take the whatever it is divisions. Okay, how this will be functioning? You just see that. So this is x divided by y. Okay, so here we're getting as a one quotient and remainder. Okay, so floor we are getting as a remainder, and floor x by y will getting as your quotient, right? So give this input. Okay, give the constant to this variable. This variable as value is 2. I'm getting the remainder. Okay, so this reminder, I need to check it is equal to 0 or not. So here we have the enormous comparational statements. So equal, not equal, greater. All comparational statement, the outputs are Boolean outputs. It means that it is a true or false. If it is equal, like in C, we are using as a if statement. If this condition is true or false. If else statement. Likewise, in the comparison also, we are using this. So I want to be check that value is equal to 0. Yes, here is a function. The remainder I'm just connected to this. I'm checking it is a true or false. So here I'm getting a true or false. Okay. So I connected according to the variable as a Boolean variable here. So whenever it is true, the LED will be on. Whenever it is false, LED will be off. Okay. So let me run this program continuously. So let me give the input as 1. So it is an odd number. 2, it is an even number. So likewise, I can check the number it is even or odd. In LED, it is glowing here. So instead of this, I can modify the same program. Okay. Why I'm doing this program is I need to explain some more functions in LabVIEW to be utilizing it. Okay. So I want to display the message on the screen with respect to your application. How I'm going to display? That is just something like you're pop-upping that message, right? So right click on your block diagram. We have the dialog. We have the dialog. Here we have the all operated with the messages. Okay. So here one, we have the display message. This is the prompt message actually. So place it here. This is one, if you place on the block diagram, automatically the message, it is coming up, what the message you want to display. Okay. The number is, I can take it as even number. So this will be display when you are, this is enabled. When this is enabled, this message is display and it will be goes when the OK button has pressed. This is how it will work. Okay, I connected to this. So this I should be enabled when this will be true. I just connected to this. Here, whenever it is true, and then this message prompt will be enabled. Then it will be display what you type the message. Here. So let me run this program. Don't run this program continuously because this is the pop-up menu. If you run continuously, it automatically, continuously, it is prompting. You can't halt the program. That's what I'm going to run with the single shot run. Once, see now, the number, it is even number. So let me give it as okay. I'll change the values of input now. I given the input as 9 now. I'll go to run this program. So it is not enabled because the output where I'm getting here, it is 0. So 0 means it is disabled value, will not be going to be enabled. So for disable also, I need to be print or display the message. How I'm going to do that? Take one more dialog menu, place it here. So the number is odd. Okay. This is also enable. I should enable it. When this should be true. What I supposed to do? I should connect this through a NOT gate. Okay, take the NOT gate, connect it to this. Whenever it is zero, that is false statement, this should be enabled. Okay, now it is clear. Whenever it is true, then this will be enabled. That is true statement. Whenever it is false, this should be enabled. Clear? Now let me run this program. So don't go with the continuous run. I'll go with the single step run. See, now we can see that while running that 9, the number is odd. You're going to display on the screen. Once you press OK, then your program is terminated. Let me change one more input, 8. So the number is even. So likewise, I can see this is a simple one. So this function you can use for any kind of applications. How to use the message display on your prompt screen. For example, okay, you want to be create something, user to be login. So like type the password, your password has mismatch. You want to display something, error message you want to display. So then you can use this icon to be for utilization. Okay, so someone has raised the hands. I want to know that what may be the sir. Please share the record also. If any doubt, we can refer to it. Fine, sir. We'll definitely do that.
Sir, is it possible to explain the shortcuts first before going to the session? Shortcuts.
Fine, sir. What might be what is the way of shortcuts
finding used in the yeah finding out function? Yeah,
okay, fine, sir. Sir, one more thing you need to know, that is once you programming more and more, then only you can come to know that where maybe our functions are available. Or one way is that you should know that what I supposed to do that with respect to that function, this program. See, this is the one simple program. I need to know that this number is even or odd. So what I supposed to do? Okay, one thing, I can display the message. How are you going to display the message? On prompt wise you can display, or on the screen you can display. This is how we, or you can use the string also. You can use the string and you can display the string message there. So this is we should know before. So once you know that, then I can come to know that what kind of function it's supposed to be used. So you go with the search button, or you can see that. Or anyhow, this is a basic fundamental you should know all the one you while going programming in LabVIEW. One is structures you should know, or all these functions you should know. That's what the national instrument, preferably seeing the employees, they has to complete their CLAD certified person. CLAD certified person means you should know all these functions. This is the basic fundamentals. Even nowadays in the school level, the LabVIEW is introducing now in the other countries. So that's what here we should know. For example, I want to know the display. So you come to the display dialog menu. So here so many functions are there. So we should know that how this function it will works. Right? So I'll go with one by one. So this is only the glimpse I given you people to enrich your knowledge. So one more concept of the way is, this is in 1 hour or 2 hours is not possible to learn all the concepts. That's I given you a path you people go ahead with using the LabVIEW. So I give the glimpse what kind of functionality are there while doing the programs. Right, sir. So I'm modifying that. Definitely, sir, we'll sharing you all the contents or the manuals in the LabVIEW. You please go through that. Maybe yesterday Vishweshwaran has sent you all the manual as well as the videos, and software also he shared. Okay, some people has told me that we are not possible to install. Okay, so I'll ask the Vishweshwaran. You please mail to him. He will send you one CD for you from the national instrument. This is we can do that. No need not to worry about the installation, sir. You please mail him. Okay, with respect to I need a software CD, right? With your ID and everything, you please mail him. The people will send you the CD. Okay, through CD you can install easily. Not any problem. So maybe the installation problem, maybe problem with your system configuration, or maybe network problem. Because while downloading the software, maybe some patch file may be missing. So there may be a problem. Right, sir? So now I'll just modifying this. Instead of display on the prompt, how I'll going to display on the string. So come to the string, I need to be use the indicator here. So here, how once it is true, what the message I want to display in this string, how I supposed to put it on this. So as we know that in if C programming, if whatever that variable value it is equal to zero, printf in the character, the printf statement we written, okay, this is an even number. Okay, likewise I need to do that. So in LabVIEW we have one more function, like if else statement function. In the comparison we have the select. This how it will works. This see here I given the boolean statement here, boolean condition. With boolean condition you can give anything, not only a boolean, you can give any numerical condition or character condition you can give with this function. But here I given the boolean condition. In this boolean condition it will take the, see if it is condition is true, take this line. If it is false, it is going to take this line. Okay, so whenever it is true, what I going to transmit it to this line. Can see this is your select function. When this line has true, it your output as follows this line, true line. If it is false, your output line it follows this false line. This is how. So okay, let connect it to your string function as an output, but it is an unbroken wire because you are not given any input to this. So I supposed to give an input. What input I supposed to give it here? So go to string, we have the string constant here. Okay, so here you type this is even number. So just I type the even, I connect it to this. So whenever it is true, your output is follows this statement. Clear? Same way I copy and pasting here, I change the statement, I connect it to odd here. Whenever it is false, it is connected to or. Okay, so let me run this program. See, in the first it is executed here in the prompt, the number it is even. Okay, I made it as okay, your output has shown as even. So let me delete these things. Control B is your eliminating your broken wire. Now see, now this function whatever I use select line, continuously I'll going to run this because it is not created any prompt here. Okay, now we can change the inputs. So whenever it is 9, it display it is odd. So whenever it is false, the output is selected your false statement. I'll change the input here 10. Okay, it is true. Now true condition is even it is displaying on the screen. So see, while seeing this program, it is very simple. Same program if you want to be implemented in C or C++. So maybe you should know all kind of syntax, all kind of how to utilize the comparison statement or checking that number or finding the remainder. It's all very difficult in the text programming. So this is how we can say that This is how we can say that graphical programming is very easy to understand and it is very reliable. Okay, so maybe the session has timed out. So we'll stop today here. Tomorrow we'll go with some more function. We'll come to the looping structures. Then it is very interesting part. And also we'll come to the creating a sub VI functions and while loop, for loop and structures, event structures. All we can come to know that how we going to programming on this. Okay. So any doubts, please clarify me.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
If you can provide a full official manual via mail, yes, then we can work on ourselves more while we are at
definitely,
home.
Sir. Definitely, definitely, sir. We'll give you that because I came to know that we have the manual. Okay, but how do implementing the manual in practical concept? That is a problem, sir. That's what this kind of workshops will give you the hints. Okay, this is how we can do that. So with this knowledge, definitely with the manual, we can enrich your knowledge.
Yes, yes, yes. That's what I mean.
Yes. We'll share you all the manual contents.
Yes, please. Thank you.
Okay. From this today session, any things you want to discuss? Thank you very much. Thank you.